The President, please be seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is now back in session.
L'audience est reprise.
We would like to now hand over to counsels for Nunchi to proceed with the remainder of the questions. You
pour la fin de son interrogatoire.
Vous disposez d'une heure and 20 minutes.
Et d'une heure et 20 minutes.
So you can proceed until 2:40.
Vous avez donc la parole jusqu'à 14h40.
Thank you, Mr. President, Mr. Yuk Cheng.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Just to announce the order of things for this afternoon, I will finish up my line of questioning and then I will, with your permission, give the floor to Mr. Sonaroun, the National Counsel for Mr. Nunchi.
Vous posera des questions.
I would like to start, Mr. Yuk Cheng, by showing you a article, an academic article by Mr. Stephen Heder. It is called Reassessing the Role of Senior Leaders and Local Officials in Democratic Kampuchea. And the ERN is 0066-1455, and it runs until 0066-1491. And if we can maybe show the first page of this article on the screen, then you can see what I'm talking about.
Première page 0066485. Peut-être peut-on vous projeter le document pour que vous sachiez de quoi je parle.
This is the first page. I'm not sure if you, Mr. Witness, see the first page. And then if we
première page de cet article.
Move down a bit to page 36 and look at footnotes 207 and 208 of this article. There we see it in the screen, and those footnotes read, various evidence implicates Heng Samrin in war crimes, massacres of Vietnamese civilians committed by troops under his command during cross-border raids into Vietnam in 1977. And footnote 208 reads, TSM has been accused of responsibility for murders of new people and others in the district of which he was secretary, Pontiacrec, in sector 20 of the East Zone. And then a bit further down, it continues, local informants estimate that thousands of people were killed at the district security office while TSM was district secretary, with the worst killings under his rule coming in late 1977 and early 1978.
This,
again, comes from an article by Mr. Steve Heder. We've spoken about him a lot during the last hearings. He is widely considered to be an expert on DK era documents. And my question to you is, was DCCAM allowed to access government archives regarding these alleged crimes that Mr. Heder is referring to in these footnotes?
Sur les sujets dont parle Steve Heder dans ses notes de bas de page.
The President, witness, hold on, please.
Veuillez attendre.
The President, the Chamber decides that a witness shall not respond to the question as it is irrelevant.
The question was irrelevant. Pas pertinente. Il s'agit d'une question dénuée de pertinence. Maître Pas.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
Accountability project that we've spoken about a lot has been doing research throughout Cambodia, and my question is, to your knowledge, has the accountability project conducted interviews in the Pontiacrec district, which is the district where, according to this footnote, crimes were committed or there. Has been accused, GSM has been accused of committing crimes in this particular district. Has DCCAM conducted research on these alleged crimes?
We object, Your Honours. You've just ruled against this line of questioning.
Vous venez tout juste de trancher et vous pouvez poser la question. Et je suggérerais que mon confrère passe à un autre sujet.
Mr. President, if I may respond, I mean, I'm not sure what the
Monsieur
line of questioning is that my colleague is referring to, but I do wish to state that it's incredibly important that these issues get the proper attention. And I think there are three reasons why we need to explore this. First reason is that we are trying to find out how DCCAM manages and processes the evidence that it actually possesses. And the question is, does it make available to the public, or more specifically to the OCP, every piece of evidence that it possesses? And does it make available to the OCP evidence that might be exculpatory for our clients? That is what I'm trying to assess by these questions. Second thing, and this will come up, so I might as well address it right straight away, we need today to explore possible government interference in the work of DCCAM. This is simply a very relevant issue considering the realities of everyday Cambodian society. It is undisputed that the Cambodian government does not shy away from interfering with this court. It does not even hesitate to directly interfere in the work of a duly appointed international co-investigating judge. And it would be naive to assume that the government would shy away from interfering in the activities of a purely Cambodian NGO, which is tasked with investigating the history of the democratic
Cambodian. The President. Council, could you please be reminded that you are now given this opportunity to put questions with relation to the documentation cataloging of other relevant documents by the DCCAM. The chamber does not allow you to make any further statement
ne vous permet pas
straying from this confined
de faire toute déclaration sortant du cadre
topics.
Déjà
if établi. You do not have further questions,
si vous
then
we
may end it now.
La chambre
the
peut mettre
prosecutor
fin à votre temps de parole.
Objection just now
l'objection
is
du procureur
sustained
est retenue.
And that you are not allowed to proceed with the same line of questions.
Et vous ne pouvez pas poursuivre sur cette série de questions.
Please be advised that you are now asked to put questions that are relevant to the main object
vous devez poser
or subject matters for the discussion during
this sujet prévu
hearings.
Pour l'audience d'aujourd'hui.
And you need to put questions relevant to the methods in collecting documents, cataloging them,
les méthodes de collecte,
and storing,
le catalogage
and,
et l'entreposage des documents.
Witness is not supposed to be put questions concern each and particular or specific document
sur des documents précis.
Any challenge to a specific document will be done at a later date.
Si
the chamber hopes that the message has already been
clear.
Cette question
sera tranchée plus tard. Nous espérons donc que le message est clair.
Thank you, Mr. President. I will move away from this specific body of evidence that would implicate current high-ranking officials. And I will move on to the next topic. Mr. Stephen Hatter, in this article, develops the theory based on his research of the evidence that a substantial part of the killing that occurred in Cambodia was committed by lower-ranking CPK officials without specific instructions of the central leadership. And just to introduce my question, let me first ask you, are you familiar with this particular theory of
Steve Hatter? C'est ma première question.
Réponse. That Steve Hedder's theory and his analysis, and I'm
c'est la théorie de Steve Hedder et son analyse.
Talk about this and
people we interviewed,
more than 1,000 people
nous avons mené plus
who have
de
been interviewed never admitted that they have killed
et dans
anyone.
Ce millier d'interviews, pas une seule n'a admis avoir tué qui que ce soit.
Thank you. And
question. Je vous remercie.
From your own publications, we know that you do research to illuminate the chains of commands in order to hold the senior leaders accountable for the crimes committed. Has DCCAM conducted any specific research to corroborate Hedder's theory that a substantial part of the killing was committed by lower-ranking CPK officials without specific instructions of the central leadership?
Reçu d'instructions spécifiques du leadership du centre.
Response. As stated, this project was carried out when we interviewed former combatants of the DK. Following
the biographies of
them we obtained, we were wanting to know who killed the people back then. We did not follow Mr. Steve Hedder's idea and whether he used our idea to be integrated into his paper.
Et
it is his own decision. And as I already said,
article,
more than 1,000 people
dit,
we interviewed, none of them said they committed such crime or have ever killed anyone.
De crime ou d'avoir tué qui que ce soit.
Thank you. Then I would like
question.
To
merci.
End this particular segment by showing you the last page of Mr. Hedder's article, if it can be shown on the screen, in the red box. And I will read it for you, the last part. And Mr. Hedder opines that a proper legal and historical accounting requires much broader and deeper investigations that do not exempt from scrutiny CPK era small fish, regardless of their current place in Cambodian society.
And
let me put it to you that Mr. Hedder has studied all this evidence for several decades now. Much like you, he has made the DK era his life's work, and after studying all this evidence, he concludes that a proper legal and historical accounting requires much broader and deeper investigations. You, as a director of a historical research organization, do you agree with this assessment by Steve Hedder?
Cette déclaration de Steve Hedder?
We would object to this, Your Honours, again.
Une fois de plus,
and Mr. President was very kind to read out the Chamber's instructions with respect to this hearing. I think the Chamber's been very generous in granting counsel extra time, but I feel we're wasting time now. We're just veering into areas which have nothing to do with the documents that are in the case file, their origin, authenticity, and reliability, and exploring matters which are way beyond the purposes of this hearing. And if counsel has run out of ideas, I would encourage Your Honour to simply ask him to hand over the floor to his colleague.
N'a plus d'idées pour des questions à poser à témoin, qu'il laisse la parole à son confrère.
Chamber has indeed been kind to offer us extra time.
En effet, la chambre était très généreuse.
This is again what we feel is
un temps supplémentaire.
An incredibly important issue.
It is
again the approach by DCCAM to the collection of evidence.
I
will clearly accept your ruling on whether this question should be answered or not, and I'm happy to move on, but it is an issue that we feel needs to be addressed sooner or later. So
I
will now conclude my part of the questioning because too many questions that I want to ask, I cannot ask because of your directions.
We have, as far as we are concerned,
barely scratched the surface of the topics that we want to discuss, which is again EasyCAM, possible bias in collecting evidence and the way it has been analyzing this evidence.
We would
already announced that we would want.
Nous avons déjà
the president interrupts. The chamber has already made this clear that you are not allowed to make any further statements.
De faire d'autres
you
déclarations.
Are allowed to only put questions
vous
to the witness,
poser des questions aux témoins.
Questions that are relevant to the agreed subject
vous ne pouvez
matter.
Poser que des questions qui sont
we
pertinentes
have
sur le sujet
so far had problems to
prévu.
Do with the documents and you are supposed to address these issues
vous
in this courtroom and if you insist moving with the questions that are banned
si
by the chamber then we suggest that your request for additional time will now end here.
Suggérons de mettre fin au temps supplémentaire qui vous a été accordé.
The question that you just put and objected by the prosecutor
la question que vous venez de poser fait l'objet d'une objection
taken
de l'accusation
by the chamber as
une objection
the objection itself is sustained and witness cannot be forced to respond to any questions or any issues or opinion by any other author and
à des opinions exprimées par d'autres
the chamber
auteurs.
Notes that even the witness may be allowed to do so, but if the topic is outside the subject matter, such issue shall be also disallowed.
Le
témoin thank
ne peut
you,
répondre
Mr. President.
Sur des
I understand
questions
your instructions, and I am actually ending my part of the cross-examination of this witness at this stage.
Mon
I just have two procedural points that I want to make, and I think it's convenient if I do it before Mr. Sonnaroun takes the floor.
Que je le fasse
one thing is that we do request the trial chamber to request Mr. Yuk-Chang to provide the information that we discussed this morning, and which is the information that can be found in those so-called notes 316 and note 317, which is information as to whether the document at EasyCAM is an original or not, and
renseignement indiquant si
in box 317, the information
non,
as to the provenance of the document and earlier custodians. We think this would clarify
précédents.
A lot of issues, and we would want Yuk-Chang to do that
cela
for all
de
the documents that appear on
choses,
the list that has been provided by the OCP,
la
the list of documents
that
come
sur
from
la liste
EasyCAM.
De
so that would be our first request.
The
second request, I'm not sure if now is the time and place
et
to do so,
seconde,
but
je ne sais pas si le moment est opportun
just in case, we announced that we would want to hear this witness again on the issues that we have not been allowed to ask him questions on,
sur les questions
which is, I'm not going to repeat myself, but these issues are of crucial importance. It's an unprecedented situation that a private organization has been so instrumental in the collection of evidence in a criminal case.
Est travaillé, est fourni tant d'éléments de preuve dans une affaire au pénal. Le président
the president interrupts. Counsel,
maître,
the chamber has made this clear and again that the floor is not for you to make any general statement. It is about the questions concerning subject matter of documentation and the
EasyCAM.
You cannot take the advantage of this venue to put
vous ne pouvez profiter
other
de votre temps de parole
statement which are
pour
not
faire
relevant
des déclarations
to this particular
qui
time
dénuées
given.
De pertinence
you
pour
indeed can
d'aujourd'hui.
Do so in another session
vous pouvez le faire
when It is the result for such purpose,
audience,
but not
qui serait prévu à cet effet, mais pas aujourd'hui.
Thank you, Mr. President, for your instructions, and with your permission, I will give the floor to my national colleague, Mr.
Et avec votre permission, je laisse la parole à mon confrère, Maître Son Arun.
The President.
Le Président.
To clarify matters.
La Chambre souhaite apporter quelques précisions.
The Chamber would like Counsel for Nguyen Chi to be on his feet, and we would like to hand over to Judge Lavergne
nous souhaitons laisser la parole au juge Lavergne
counsel for clarification.
Pour quelques questions qu'il aurait pour la défense de Nguyen Chi.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président.
La
Chambre
souhaiterait
que vous apportiez quelques clarifications quant à votre requête que vous venez de lui soumettre, requête tendant à voir obtenir des informations quant à la source, quant à l'état des documents provenant de DCCAM et qui figurent au dossier. La première question que nous aurions à vous poser est de savoir si de telles demandes d'informations ont été faites au cours des trois années d'instruction préparatoire et si vous n'avez pas eu jusqu'à présent l'occasion de vous rendre à DCCAM pour obtenir ce type d'information. La seconde chose, c'est que votre requête pourrait éventuellement concerner l'application des dispositions du règlement intérieur et notamment de ces dispositions de la règle 87.4 concernant de nouveaux éléments de preuve dont il est demandé la production au débat. Et je vous rappelle que l'article 87.4 prévoit ceci. The requesting party must also satisfy the chamber that the requested testimony or evidence was not available before the opening of the
trial. Le juge Lavergne cite la règle 87.4.
Thank you, Judge Lavergne. I will try to be brief in my response. First answer to the answer to the first question would be no, we did not try to establish the provenance of every document that is on the OCP list that was provided 2 weeks ago, simply because we had no way of knowing which documents the OCP would be relying on at this point of the trial, especially considering the fact that clearly we had no idea that the trial would be organized in this way, with a mini trial and a subsection of documents. If the question is whether or not we were able to verify the provenance of these documents earlier, I think this is exactly what the hearing last week was about, and the hearing this morning was about finding out what DSICAM did, how they collect and store documents. It's only this morning that we established that DSICAM indeed enters this information in such a database, and that this box 316 and box 317 exists. Today, I clarified with Mr. Yuk Chang that indeed this box contains the information that we have all been looking for the past few weeks. Even Mr. Yuk Chang is not entirely clear on what can be found in those boxes, but it seems to me that today we established that there is good hope that what we are looking for here today, which is again the provenance of the documents and the chain of custody of documents, can indeed be found in this particular database and in this particular box 316 and 317. So that's the reason that I would ask DSICAM to provide this information today. I would submit that, in fact, it was not for us to come up with this line of questioning and to establish what the provenance of these documents was. I would have submitted, or I submit, that it would have been up to the OCP, or at a later stage, the OCIJ, to establish that indeed this information is available at DSICAM.
So,
this is how I understand your question, but I don't want to read too much into it. If the line of thinking would be that we are late in making this request, I would say, A, we only established today that this information is likely available, and B, it was not for us to come up with this information. It is for the party that wants to use this information as evidence. I think this partly answers the question, the second question that you ask, which is whether this information was available before the trial started. Again, we discovered it today that this is, in fact, information that is contained in these boxes 316 and 317.
And
today's questioning has led us to make this request. This, I hope, this answers your question.
À présenter cette requête. J'espère que cela répond à votre question, Monsieur le Juge.
President, the prosecutor, you may now proceed.
Your Honours, I don't wish to interrupt Judge Laverne's questioning, so I just wish to indicate that we wish to respond to these submissions. There are matters of fact that are on the record that relate to these various submissions. I can either correct the record now, or if Your Honours wish to hear me, following questioning by Judge Laverne, I'll proceed
dès maintenant ou après avoir entendu le juge Laverne.
The President, the International Co-Prosecutor,
je vous en prie, allez-y.
You may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'll be very brief, but I do wish to correct the record, or at least state for your honours some of the relevant developments.
And just as a
starting point,
tout d'abord,
my friend insists
mon
on
confrère,
apparently comprehensive inquiry into provenance and chain of custody of each document.
Of course, Your Honours have ruled
recently that that is not required for the purposes of admission, and one only need read your latest memorandum of the 31st of January of 2012 at paragraph 2. Your Honours make it clear that documents need only satisfy
the
prima facie standards of relevance, reliability and authenticity. And unless documents appear to be forgeries
et que si un document
or unrepresentative of the originals, that the Chamber will consider them to be put before it. And our submission is that standard has indeed been met. If my friend were to challenge specific
documents,
the origin of which he puts in question
on
relevance and reliability, perhaps we would show some, we certainly show a degree of understanding, but this tendency to insist on a wide-ranging inquiry into documents is simply not in accordance with your judge's rulings and is completely beyond what is required for the purposes of admission. And further to that, on the issue of due diligence, one only need look at the date of this manual. It's dated 1999. One presumes it's been on the DCCAM website this entire period. And continuing in relation to the counsel's knowledge of documents arriving from DCCAM, again, if you look at the case file or its phase that relates to the judicial investigation, you'll find any number of filings that relate to the collection and use of documents from DCCAM. And just one of them was by the OCP, number
D313,
where we indicated at paragraph, I believe, 25, that acting in accordance with the directions of the co-investigating judges, we availed ourselves of the opportunity to visit DCCAM and to look at the records there and collect relevant documents, since DCCAM was a general publicly available database or archive, in respect of which we were instructed by the co-investigating judges that all parties were allowed to conduct inquiries, collect documents, etc. We filed, this particular filing was dated the 31st of December 2009, well before the closure of the judicial investigation. There was no response from counsel then to say that with respect to the documents that we collected at DCCAM that we needed to indicate, I'll slow down for the interpreters, I apologize. There was no indication then from counsel for Nuancia, for that matter, from any other defence team that the OCP should go back and obtain evidence as to the provenance and chain of custody. We were, of course, alleging that all of these documents were relevant, and they're among the documents that are in the table that we've been discussing. Our position is simply that the test which Your Honours have stated has been met in respect of these documents. You've now heard, I believe, 5 days of evidence on origin, chain of custody, processing, etc., to now suggest that this is the first opportunity that counsel have had to carry out a broader inquiry, and that such a broader inquiry is warranted is simply disingenuous. All of these documents have been on the case file for 2-3 years or longer, and I believe there were plenty of opportunities for requests of this type to be made, and my learned friend has indicated that such requests were not made by them. And I would suggest that at this stage, this type of a request can only tend to prolong the proceedings.
Ne serait être interprété autrement que comme étant de nature à prolonger la procédure.
If I may respond to these matters, again, I think that my colleague at the OCP turns around the burden of proof on this issue.
La charge de la preuve.
It is not for us
ce
to authenticate documents that the OCP wants to rely on.
Sur le
if the OCP wants to use
si
documents as evidence, they need to provide us
preuve,
with enough information to make sure that we can verify whether these documents are authentic and reliable. This is what the hearing in the past few weeks has been about. And during this hearing, as could have been expected, important information has surfaced as to the way that DCCAM has stored and managed its, its information. For example, we have noted that apparently no written notes have been taken when DCCAM spoke to people that handed over certain documents. That is relevant information that only surfaced during this hearing. It is for this reason that now this issue has become urgent and we need to be able to establish it further. And the OCP refers to it as a comprehensive reinvestigation of the issue of provenance. This is exactly what I am not asking. This is the reason that I inquire today whether this information in box 316 and box 317 is readily available. And as far as I understand IT,
je crois
it should be very easy
que du point de vue technique,
to simply link
il serait
specific documents
facile
with this box 316 and 317
d'établir un
and
just provide us entre certains documents précis
two columns,
et
one column
ces cases
with
316
box
316
information, one column with box 317
316,
information,
une autre colonne avec
then
la
we will be able to verify whether
à ce
the chain of custody
si
and
la
earlier custodians
de conservation
have been
et l'identité
adequately
des anciens
documented.
Détenteurs
I
documents ont été dûment documentés.
Will say that I doubt that is the case for many
que
documents.
Cela soit le cas pour ce qui est d'un grand nombre de
documents.
Also,
considering what I just mentioned
compte tenu de ce que je viens
with regard to earlier notes that have not been taken relating to the collection of evidence.
Écrit concernant
and
la
this
collecte
is what we need to establish. And
preuve.
Again,
c'est cela
it was
qu'il
up for the OCP to establish this when they wanted to rely on these documents.
Ont prétendu
if we speak about due diligence, I think
si l'on parle
it's the OCP
diligence
raisonnable, that has failed to be due diligence in this issue, and it's actually the whole reason that we now need to have this
diligence
hearing that has cost
à cause de
this court
nous sommes
many, many days of questioning already.
It's
now
plusieurs journées d'interrogatoire.
Fair to look at the defense and place the burden on us. Again, it is up to the OCP and we are now offering the OCP an opportunity to basically help it in the authentication of the documents by simply providing us that information in boxes 316 and 317. We're here to talk about the truth.
Nous sommes là pour parler de vérité.
The truth regarding these documents
la vérité concernant
is
ces documents
crucial and this
crucial,
truth is
cette
easily
vérité
findable in DCCAM's archives. So we would request
être
to have that information added to the case file to properly verify the authenticity of these documents.
Être versées au dossier en vue de vérifier l'authenticité des documents en question. Le président.
Thank you.
Merci.
President, with respect to the request made by the Defense Council for Nunchia, the Chamber will respond to it in due course.
La Chambre se prononcera en temps utile.
Now the floor is given to Mr. Sonarun to continue putting questions to the witness.
Qui pourra poursuivre l'interrogatoire du témoin.
Counsel
Sonarun.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président.
Good morning, Your Honours.
Bonjour, Madame, Messieurs les juges.
Good afternoon. For your honor information, I have 20 questions to ask.
J'ai 20 questions
the President,
le président.
You have up to 2:40 today to put your question.
Vous avez jusqu'à 14h40.
So you should use the remaining time for your question. And the chamber did advise a party in relation to the time available for the Defense Council this afternoon.
À la défense, de combien de temps elle disposait
Counsel
pour cet après-midi.
Sonarun. Thank you, Mr. President, for your
Merci,
direction,
Monsieur le
and I will limit my question to the time allotted.
Je
Good afternoon, Mr. Chang-yuk. I would like to begin
Monsieur
with my first
Chang-yuk,
question.
Bon après-midi.
In
la première question est la suivante.
Statement take. In the statement taken by the OCIJ document D2.2/7 dated 2007,
le document
I would like to check with you the document that were stored in the DC CAM. You mentioned that those documents are the contemporaneous DK
documents. D'époque,
so my question
à la période du Cambodge démocratique.
Do all, are all the documents you have in your
Est-ce
possession
tous les documents qui sont en votre
original
possession
documents?
Sont les documents originaux?
Answer.
Réponse.
We have some original documents
Nous avons
and
des originaux
some copied documents.
Et des copies.
Question.
Question.
In your last line of the statement, you say that
à
those documents
are vous dites
authenticated. In other words, they are copied properly from the originals. What did you mean? Can you clarify?
Answer.
I refer to the documents from the Swedish collection. We had them copied and transported it to the DC CAM. And as well as the documents that we discovered later on, that Cornell University made it into microfilm from the document left in Tools Lang. And we made copy of
à
those documents
l'Université Cornell a fait des
and kept them at
nous
the DC CAM and we
leave
the originals
in
the Tools Lang
Museum.
Question.
Question.
If I understand correctly,
si j'ai bien compris,
when we talk about original documents, it means that they are the originals
ce sont vraiment
of
les originaux.
The document. Answer. Réponse. Original documents refer to the ones
Lorsqu'on
which has not been
ce sont
copied.
Des documents
For example,
qui
the document
pas été
originated
copiés.
From the Democratic Cambodia
Par
and
exemple,
they have not been copied by others, and the paper presentation reflects the one used during the regime. But if those papers were scanned, they look
Lorsque
different.
On constate que le papier est bien celui employé à l'époque. Lorsqu'un scanogramme a été effectué, le papier est différent. Pour les originaux, ils sont en couleur et il
question.
Peut y avoir également des notes manuscrites dessus. Question.
When you say that they were the original, what was
Vous
your
documents
criteria for assessment
Quel
of
est
the original
le critère
documents?
Pour établir le caractère original
answer.
D'un document?
Are you referring to the Swedish collection? Question. Well, both
Réponse.
Swedish collection
Vous
and other documents. answer. For documents located domestically, I got them copies by DCCAM. So we work with the Tours Line personnel, and we kept some at the DCCAM and left some with the Tours Line as well. So we have a TSL with serial numbers to identify certain documents that we can verify anytime.
Et la vérification est possible à tout moment.
Question.
Question.
You said in your statement with the OCIJ that those documents were consistent.
Parlé de certains documents.
And they were contemporaneous DK documents. What do you mean by consistency? Was it your sole conclusion
vous avez aussi
of that,
parlé de cohérence?
Or are you based on any criteria or evidence? Because now people can manipulate or fabricate the document in whatever way they like, taking into account the availability of technology. Answer. I can give you an example, a document that is considered the DK contemporaneous document. They use certain types of paper, and at that time they used typewriter to type documents. And in each document there is an author as well, and some author from that regime are still alive now. And there is a connection of documents, and we can track the chain of documents as well if you want to actually want to find out who wrote it in the first place. And in addition to that, we also look at the content, the words used in the document. So we have to actually understand the context as well. For example, Bhopana's confession, consisting of more than 1,000 pages long, and it involved love stories and other stuff as well. So it is a long story of that, and it was quite difficult for anyone to actually fake such document.
Et il aurait été question. Bien difficile, voire impossible, de falsifier
have you
un tel document.
Ever received
question.
Any written,
avez-vous
handwritten documents
reçu de documents
or any other documents that were handwritten, whatever documents? Have you ever received such documents? Answer. Are you talking about documents
réponse.
From the before pre-1975 or during the DK period?
Well,
question from the DK period.
La défense.
Answer. Well, I
des documents du Cambodge démocratique.
Have received Le témoin. Some. There was written records of the DK comrades, and I read one of them.
Démocratique.
And I noted that one of them was not from the Democratic Cambodia because that written note was describing about a story of a lady who migrated from France and she was executed. And I wrote another
était revenu de France, avait été exécuté.
Note as well, a record as well, about
another
story, and those notes were actually handwritten.
Et tous ces documents étaient manuscrits.
Is this the only notes or records you have received in handwriting form?
Que vous ayez reçu?
Answer.
Réponse.
Those records, 450 records, were all handwritten records
qui étaient
of the former combatants of the Democratic Cambodia. And certain records
were
written in 1972 or 1973. Thank you, says the counsel.
La défense. Merci.
Question. You told the OCIJ
au
that
juge d'instruction,
for the prefix
vous avez dit
B
que
were the document received
B
from the government as well as personal donation.
Ainsi que de certaines
are you certain that those documents are the contemporaneous DK
documents? Sont les documents d'époque?
Answer. Are you referring to letter
Est-ce que
K
vous
or
parlez de la lettre K?
Mr. Sonaron,
Maître
it was letter K.
C'est la lettre
refer
K.
To K in English. If it refers to the K documents, they are biography documents. We have never used my initial in order to code the document. We use the English alphabet. In this case, we use K.
Les interprètes
question.
Demanderaient à ce qu'ils puissent être fait une pause entre les questions et les réponses parce qu'ils ont du mal à savoir qui
they
parle.
They are marked I documents. There are documents concerning the confession
une pause entre les, une pause entre les questions et les réponses, s'il vous plaît. Merci.
Or the biography. Answer. They, of course, they are biography. I documents are the biography.
The president.
Of course, you may continue your question and answer, but the problem is that you are at times using the channel simultaneously.
It is difficult for the interpreting team to
render your questions and answer properly. So please pause in between question and answer.
Vous êtes donc prié de faire une pause entre les questions et les réponses.
Counsel Sunarun, I'm sorry, just
Maître
now I have
Sunarun,
not finished my question.
Je n'ai pas
I would
ma
like
question.
To repeat my question.
Je vais donc la répéter.
You told the co-investigating
au
judges that d'instruction, the prefix K
vous
you attached to the documents, which you said you received from the government offices as well as individual donations. Are you certain that these documents are the contemporaneous DK documents? Are you certain or it is only your
cela,
presumption?
Ou bien s'agit-il simplement de votre hypothèse?
Answer.
Réponse.
As I inform the chamber,
comme
we do not use
chambre,
the Khmer alphabet to
Khmer
code the documents. We use English alphabet instead, for example, letter I, letter K, or so. But when you refer
A
to document marked with document core, I
si
don't know, probably
de
there was a
core,
translation issue over there. But if it is the K document that refers
pas.
To the biography
de
documents.
K,
and
ça,
when we talk about biography documents, there are different types as well.
Types de
there are biographies of the former CPK officers
d'anciens
who actually
membres du PCK
wrote their own biographies,
qui ont établi leur propre
autobiographies. Others are autobiographies. And as I said, Mr. Sum Sikun or
comme
Kamrat
dit,
Kung, he
Sum
wrote
Sikun
his own biographies,
a,
and
par
others
exemple,
are
sa
biographies with the mugshot of the Kamrat or
des
any personnel working in any unit or organization. Another biography belongs to the victims, and
il y a
it reads
aussi des
the history
victimes.
Or biography of the prisoners, and
il
it consists of around 4 pages long, and it
c'est
contains a mugshot of the prisoners as well. And these kinds of documents are I documents,
ces documents
and for K documents
I,
from Tourslang, and
K,
I's are 4 biographies that we actually collected from Ministry of Interior, then we mark those document
il
I
documents,
which refer to the biographies
ça,
we obtained from
I.
Ministry of Interior. Question.
Question.
For documents you collected from
concernant
S21, you said that they are I category
vous
documents.
Que vous leur
so
la
they,
cote
are, they refer to the biography of the personnel of the
du personnel
CPK as well as the prisoner
PCK
of S21.
Ainsi que des prisonniers de S21.
And how can you distinguish between
comment
the biography kept at S21 or the confession or biography you obtained from
les aveux,
Ministry of Interior?
Les aveux, les biographies qui proviennent
as
du ministère
I
de l'Intérieur.
Informed
réponse.
The chamber
comme je l'ai
last
déjà,
week
la semaine passée,
that whoever receive the confession or hears about confession, they only consider that confession from the S21. And there was an article written by Douglas who
nous
specifies the number of confessions. At S21, there are some 4,000 confessions, and certain confessions from the Ministry of Interior, we have collected up to around 1,000 or so. And then we have verified the two types of confessions and biographies. We have noted that there are
et nous avons constaté
biographies as well,
qu'il y avait des biographies
also some,
qui se recoupaient.
Different types of confessions and biographies. But normally, what I found from Ministry of Interior contains more detailed biography or confession than the one found in the S21. So there are two kinds of confession: one from Ministry of Interior, the other from S21, and they consist of around 5,000.
Il s'agit d'environ 1000
questions. You say that confessions could come from two different sources.
Que des aveux peuvent provenir de plusieurs
sources. Is it fair to say that the person could be interviewed at the Ministry of Interior and also at
S21? Réponse.
No, no one was ever interviewed at the Ministry of Interior. It was the confessions we obtained from the MOI or Ministry of Interior. There's a confession of Khoi Thuan.
Par exemple, les aveux de
Khoi Thuan. These confessions were transferred to Santibal office.
Ont été transférés au and I guess Santibal.
People at Santibal office could have interviewed the persons further after they obtained the brief confessions from S21
quelqu'un
previously.
Plus en détail après avoir obtenu les premiers
question.
Aveux S21.
I do not question. If I have already read all the documents, but my question is that during the Democratic Cambodia, there was no
savoir.
Ministry
sous le
such as Ministry of Interior.
Il n'y avait pas de ministère de l'Intérieur.
Mr. Son Sen was the Minister of National Defense and Internal and External Security Affairs. Response. I think there is a misunderstanding here. I am referring to the documents of the Democratic Cambodia at the Ministry of Interior. I'm not talking about the Ministry of Interior that was established during the Democratic Cambodia. What I am referring to is that the confessions could have been transferred to Santibal office, and that at Santibal office, people could have interviewed the person who originally gave these testimonies for a second time. Question. You said that there were millions of documents
that
was placed on your desk and that you would enjoy reading each document.
Lire chacun de ces documents.
My question is, if the documents belong to the DK or to the government or to
si
the Senate, have you ever observed any signatures on each
Sénat.
Document?
Avez-vous vu des signatures sur ces documents?
Response, I think I Réponse. Have. Mr. President,
pense,
if you allow me to do so,
permettez.
I would like to talk further on this.
J'aimerais donner plus
to me,
de
documents, reading document
Pour
is one of my most favorite hobbies.
Lire des documents est un de mes passe-temps
Any
préférés.
Piece of document is more like a grain of rice.
Et
one could pick
document,
up during the Democratic Cambodia because everyone was so hungry, so we would not waste any grain of rice. And I noted that I read some documents with stamps, and I noted signatures by Q Sampon and also signatures by Deutsch and Comrade
J'ai vu aussi donc
so
des signatures de Kyu Sampan, du camarade Kyu, entre autres, j'ai vu en effet
question,
de tels signes.
I have noted question. Some stamps on documents.
Oui, j'ai remarqué des
the stamps representing military division and also
divisions militaires.
Stamps representing ministries.
Et aussi des
but that's all I have noted. Have you
vu.
Seen other stamps from other
d'autres?
Locations? Response.
Réponse.
I think I have seen a few more other stamps representing other places, but not much, not many.
Pas beaucoup plus.
Question. During the Democratic Cambodia regime, the
Sous le
policy was very strict. My question is,
les
how could DCKM obtain information or documents from all levels, from
the
grassroots or local grassroots level to the central center.
Centre.
Response. I think that's a good question. Why such document is kept in one place? I should refer the questions to your client as well. Why such document is kept?
Ces documents
I think I talked to a person and who knows a thing about the Khmer Rouge regime. They got their documentation team, and Susti was a member of the documentation team, and he also gave testimonies before the chamber. I asked him some questions about why, or he was asked why such a huge volume of documents was kept,
but he also
said that there was a team who was tasked with compiling or keeping documents, and that we only feel that the documents we obtain today is only a drop in the ocean. There's still plenty of other documents that could be available elsewhere. And back then, the Khmer Rouge government was a well-established one, so it could have been an institution where documents could be properly managed.
Donc, il est possible question, que les documents
I think I used to talk to Nguyen Chi and asked him some questions
to learn that
during the Democratic Cambodia, people minded their own businesses, and that a senior person only was confined to understand his or her own personal affairs rather than knowing more about other institutions. So I can go back to the question at S21, and the question remains, why should document a number of documents stored at S21, which was only a small location?
A-t-on retrouvé autant le document S21 qui était pourtant
response, I am very happy that you put question to me because when you put question in Khmer,
je suis très
really
heureux
easy
que vous me
posez
des questions. Quand vous me posez des questions en Khmer,
indeed,
plus
you perhaps misunderstand this.
Peut-être avez-vous
documents at DCCAM are not only collected from
S21. Documents de S21.
From Ben Kenan was obtained through Mr. Kiu Kanyarat, and such documents were not stored earlier at S21. And we obtained only confessions and images from S21. Other documents are obtained from other locations. In the Khmer Rouge regime, when three people were grouped, they would be called
upper echelon
organization.
So
even our group leaders in the mobile unit would also be regarded as encar. So
that was an institution.
Question. You said from 2005, there has never been any agreement concerning
2005,
documents with the tribunal.
Sur les documents avec le tribunal.
My question is, what do you think about this? Why you keep providing documents to the ECCC? Do you think that such act is not legal?
Respond.
I think I have to answer to requests by the ECCC as a judicial institution, and I provide documents non-discriminately. I give documents to any parties to the proceeding, including the public. And documents collected at DCCAM has been done so through permission from the government of Cambodia as well. Question. I think my question is more relevant. Indeed, it has been asked time again, but I would like to seek clarification. ECCC is a judicial body. I don't really care whether who you send these documents to. And DCCAM is a center, center that is responsible for providing documents to ECCC, which is a judicial body. I think ECCC has made requests for documents.
Je pense que les CETC
so we need to provide documents to them. How could you provide documents to the ECCC without memorandum being signed?
Sans qu'il y ait eu de protocole d'entente à cet égard.
It was my initial intention that I fully support the court. The tribunal. So, as an outsider of the court, I would do my best to fit the court with documents available at my center that has been collected so far. We discussed with our expert, including Kate Woodson at ICTY, and that's why we proposed the idea of having a memo being signed with Michelle Lee representing the court back then, because we would like to make sure that it is a proper
and qu'il y ait une procédure en place.
However, although we have not signed the contract, we kept people who requested for the document informed of the cost in producing the document to them. I talked to Knut and Tony Krein concerning my request because I was very concerned that this would prolong the proceedings, and as I indicated, I did my best to support the court and that we would like everything to be done in legally.
Tout soit fait de façon légale.
Question. When you receive documents from a foreign country, the documents would only be in a foreign language. Now, with regard to the black paper, or the revolutionary flag in particulier. My client said that the flag at the beginning was written by written by hand.
Écrit à la main.
But then when the documents went all the way to Sweden,
mais les documents se sont retrouvés en Suède.
Then it was converted into French. Can we call it French original documents?
Peut-on dire qu'il s'agit d'un original
response,
en français?
I have never seen revolutionary flag in French.
Je n'ai jamais vu l'étendard révolutionnaire en français.
Perhaps you have mistaken.
Peut-être faites-vous erreur.
According to my observation, I think even in the revolutionary flags magazines themselves, there were photos of your
même
client,
Nguyen Chia. Dans l'étendard révolutionnaire, vous-même, il y avait des photos de votre
in
client,
particular, and these documents were produced in 1975, and they remain. And in my office, you can find those copies.
Et vous pouvez voir dans mon bureau.
So, I would like to make it clear that Mr. Sonarun don't misunderstand. We have the magazines and bulletins and journals.
Les bulletins, des journaux.
I think Uncle Nguyen, I prefer using Uncle Nguyen because I respect him as a senior person.
Refer
to 1950s when such magazines could have been produced in handwriting. But later on, they developed. And again, I would like to make it clear there is no revolutionary flag magazine at DCCAM that is in Swedish.
Question.
I would like to also question you concerning this revolutionary flag. Nguyen Chia is not here, but he was here this morning.
Monsieur Nguyen Chia n'est pas avec nous, mais il était avec nous ce matin. Il a dit.
And he always challenged the production of a revolutionary flag when co-prosecutor raised put the document before the court or show it to him, because he said that that document was not original.
Car il a toujours dit
so
que
he said that he did not want to answer to any question with reference to the copy of document that lack its originality. So that's why I myself try to locate those documents so that if we can trace the original documents, then my client would be more cooperative to respond to questions put to him. Response. I think maybe we put it this way to help his memory. I know that these things happened many years ago.
Ces événements se sont produits il y a bien longtemps.
People need to stimulate his memory. I think there is another book, novel, even during the Khmer Rouge regime, there was also novel, Comrade Sai.
Il y avait aussi un roman sous le Cambodge démocratique. Le camarade Sai.
The book, the book was handwritten.
C'était un livre qui avait été écrit à la main.
Perhaps we need to collect some other documents to help promote his memory or refresh his memory of the events. If he still argued that the revolutionary flags were only written by hand, we may look at the novel concerning the person named Chao Sai.
Par exemple, peut-être
the president interrupts counsel. Could you please indicate how much time would you need to put the remainder of the question? Because
Maître,
it's already 10 minutes past your allocated time. We also note that Nguyen Chia may have mistaken for the revolutionary flags that produced during the 1960s that he claimed were handwritten. But then there also were magazines that were later on produced
in August 1975
through printed media. He indicated that it was impossible to locate people who had knowledge of publishing the book back then. That's why only later that the revolutionary flags could be made available in printing rather than by hand writing as indicated. We suggest that counsel did some
Chambre
homework very well with regard to the sources of these documents before putting the question to witness. Otherwise, you would drag on and there will be more confusion. How much time would you need further on this?
De combien de temps avez-vous besoin?
Counsel Sonaron, if the chamber allows, I would need only 15 more minutes or I can also be stopped.
On peut aussi
the President, indeed, the
Le
Chamber
président.
Give you 12
la
minutes.
Chambre vous donne 12 minutes.
Please make the most
Veuillez
of your allocated time.
Bien utiliser ces 12 minutes.
Use it effectively, wisely, and try to avoid repeated questions.
Les répétitions.
And the questions themselves shall be precise. To save your time.
S'il vous plaît, soyez précis afin d'économiser le plus de temps
possible. Question.
Question.
In the same document, you stated that the five
document,
different kind of documents, paper, based document, minutes
papier,
of the meeting, biographies,
des comptes rendus de réunion, des biographies.
And also the locations of the
et aussi
pits. We want to know whether all these documents produced before the Khmer Rouge or after the Khmer Rouge era, regime. response. I think
all
images have been obtained from the Democratic Cambodia regime. I think I heard somebody talking in the background. Could you please make sure the mic was not activated when you talked? Well, I would like to continue. I think the images were from not only S21,
but
from the collection of senior leaders who could be taken by photographers, whose photo could have been taken by photographers on their trips to other locations, like on trains
or
in other locations. It's not difficult to identify them because their photos were there. Some photos have been traced all the way to France. They disappeared from Cambodia, but they were located in France, including the film. We have some films that are produced after the Khmer Rouge regime by the East Germany and Yugoslavia. These films have been returned to us on the condition that they shall not be reproduced, because we do not want to create the image that the movies or the film could have been perceived to have been produced after the regime. Richard Roger visited our office to inspect the films, and we also made them available to them, but on the condition that the films must not be reproduced or copied, because we want to avoid, as I indicated, the notion that people would say the films could have been produced after the regime.
Disent que ces films ont été produits après le régime.
And the documents concerning films were returned to Cambodia, and we obtained several other images. Not necessarily from
Cambodge,
S21. Council Sonarona, thank you. I got another question
Christian.
To pose.
Bonjour, merci. J'ai but before that,
I would like to explain a bit.
Avant tout
according to the statement, the
204/2,
you indicated that the original documents that relevant to Krang Ta Chan were missing. Only the copied versions remain. And the question was put to you, why such documents were missing, were they stolen, and where are they now, and when they weren't missing? Response. I think if you read the whole transcript itself, you would see who I met first. I met His Excellency Su Piren. I met Tin Sok Kai, locating the original documents. After the regime collapsed, documents were scattered. And that some documents were copied and placed at Tuol Slang for its archive.
Aux archives de Tuol Slang.
And my approach is to locate people who may have knowledge of the documents.
And
among the many prisons all across the country, people say that only at Tuol Slang that documents were kept.
Que l'on conservait des documents.
We try to contact victims or relatives of those who were detained at Krang Ta Chan prison to locate the relevant documents and its provenance. I think my first impression with regard to this document was when I read Ben Kiernan's book concerning that prison, but there was no more documents left that pointing to Krang Tachan.
Parlant de Krang Tachan.
The deputy chief of Krang Tachan, also named Deutsch, but
de ce prison s'appelait aussi Deutsch.
And another artist still alive,
qui
also the former staff at Krang Tachan,
who was asked,
but still we could not locate the original documents.
On lui a posé des questions, mais nous n'avons pas pu retrouver les documents originaux.
Question, in 1979, the Vietnamese troop controlled the country, and at each ministry there were Vietnamese experts, including experts who managed documentation. Vietnamese entered Phnom Penh and started collecting and organizing documents.
Et à organiser les documents.
My question is,
ma question,
The question back then was that could the Vietnamese fabricate the documents collected in substance, for example?
Et monter.
So this question can be now put to you whether it is possible.
Recueilli.
Respond, I think
vous demander si c'est possible.
It is impossible.
Réponse, c'est impossible.
Only the very well, a very good expert who could really fabricate such document in huge amount. For example, when it comes to the term dialectical materialism, no one could ever imagine of how such terms could be used during the Khmer Rouge regime, and these terms appear in several other documents that identifying the
et pourtant, on retrouve ce terme dans des documents parlant de la terminologie du régime.
I think back in the Democratic Cambodia, although people were forced to work at the labor sites, or at later date, when the Vietnam entered Phnom Penh, there were people who had to work, although they had very little food.
But they worked very hard
to collect documents along with the Vietnamese.
Recueillir les documents avec
and the documents were written in Khmer.
Les documents étaient
so I could not really imagine if any Vietnamese expert could produce very detailed information on those 100,000 pages of documents. And as I indicated, the very jargon used by the Khmer Rouge, dialectical Khmer materialism, the term in Khmer is not really understood by many of us here.
Dialectique. Beaucoup d'entre nous ne savons même pas ce que cela veut dire en Khmer.
Thank you, Mr. President. I have no further
maître
questions.
Maître Sonarun, je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Je n'ai
the
plus de questions pour le
thank
témoin.
You, counsel, and it is now
merci,
appropriate
maître.
Time for the adjournment as well. The chamber would like to thank you,
la chambre souhaite remercier
Mr. Chang Yu, very much for your time and effort to give testimonies
merci.
Before the chamber.
Vous avez pris de votre temps pour
the chamber notes
la chambre.
That the hearing of your testimonies today comes to a completion and
voilà
that you will be
comparution.
Excused.
Et nous vous remercions.
So the process concerning the documentation at DCCAM and how documents are collected have already been heard,
nous avons donc entendu
and we thank you very much indeed for your time again.
The
court officer is now instructed along with the WESU to assist witness so that he can be returned home safe and sound. According to our schedule, we should conclude the session by 4 p.m. today. However, since counsel for inquiry indicated that they would not wish to put questions. That's why we had to adjourn this hearing earlier. So the next session will be resumed on Wednesday at 9 a.m. Proceeded with Nguyen Chia questioning to Nguyen Chia. Counsel for the civil party, you may proceed.
Oui, Monsieur le Président, pardonnez-moi, mais puis-je demander à la Chambre de nous éclairer, ou du moins de m'éclairer moi, sur les audiences de mercredi et jeudi, parce que j'ai cru comprendre qu'il y aurait des audiences le matin sur Nguyen Chia, mais je voudrais être sûre que les audiences sont limitées à la matinée, si la Chambre pouvait me préciser cet élément. Je l'en remercie.
The President.
Le Président.
Thank you. With regard to the scheduling of the hearing,
concernant le calendrier indeed, des audiences.
There will be changes occasionally, and the Chamber has already
la Chambre
indicated
a déjà indiqué
to the parties that the management of case file 002 is complicated, and that
la gestion
we
de ce procès
would
est une
do
question
our
complexe
best to inform to the parties,
et que la Chambre
to the best of our knowledge, of the future scheduling of any hearing.
De la suite des
and on Wednesday and Thursday this week,
mercredi
the Chamber
et jeudi,
will proceed with the hearings on
la Chambre
Nguyen
va poursuivre l'interrogatoire
Nguyen Chia. Nguyen Chia's counsel will proceed with questions according to the allocated time to the counsels for the morning session. Then the Chamber will proceed
cela,
to discuss
ce sera durant la
matters concerning
ensuite,
documents
la Chambre traitera de certaines
issued
questions
to be put before the Chamber.
Aux documents produits devant elle.
And for the following week,
concernant
the Chamber has already indicated to the parties,
comme la Chambre l'a déjà indiqué aux parties,
in particular, pursuant to the scheduling order, and also with relevance to the filing of documents.
Les débats seront consacrés à la question du dépôt des documents.
The subject matters remain the historical background of the Democratic Cambodia.
Ils sont en question du contexte historique.
And we will also proceed to the structure of the administration
et des structures administratives
and communications of the Khmer Rouge
ainsi que des
communication system. So these are the orders of the facts
voilà
to be discussed during the following sessions. Security personnel are now instructed to bring the accused persons back to the detention
Sécurité
facility and return them to the courtroom by Wednesday 9 p.m. The court is now adjourned.
Pour mercredi à 9 h.